As a coastal system shaped by waves and tides, salt marshes are both dynamic and vulnerable to change. They're filled with salt-tolerant vegetation that thrive in the harsh environments formed throughout centuries all over the world. These natural buffer zones protect and defend our coasts from storms, absorb and sequester carbon from our atmosphere, and offer habitats to diverse communities of flora and fauna. However, our coasts are shifting and our climate is changing, with sea levels rising faster than ever in recent years. In this global climate emergency, storms are escalating, bringing more intense waves and higher stresses to our salt marsh ecosystems. Concerns escalate as these ecosystems are increasingly recognized for their valuable resource to our shores, yet they're under threat and disappearing rapidly. This particular area, Appin Marsh, is a designated SSSI area by the Scottish Natural Heritage, so the marsh is protected along with the many ecosystem services it provides. The salt marsh's most economically valuable service is coastal defense. Salt marshes are key to coastal protection as they dissipate wave energy, up to 50% in the first 10 to 20 meters of vegetated marsh. This single ecosystem service provides at least £3 billion sterling worth of capital savings in sea defense costs in England alone. The large biological diversity salt marshes provide contribute heavily to the coast's cultural and regulating services. These ecosystems provide recreational opportunities for the community, breeding areas for birds, and nursery grounds for many fish taxa, including commercially important species such as sea bass and herring. Lastly, with the UK's salt marsh carbon stocks estimated to hold at least 6.8 megatons of carbon, and their capture capacity for the next 40 years being valued at about £1 billion sterling, salt marshes will play a large role in future mitigation and adaptation. However, if current trends of habitat loss continue, the salt marsh's capture capacity and carbon stores will be significantly reduced, along with a devaluation of about £250 million sterling. As society has become aware of the environmental and economic values of salt marshes, efforts have begun to slow their retreat and restore damaged marshes. These started as local initiatives, but now restoration of coastal marshes is also included among national strategies for climate adaptation planning, highlighting the multiple benefits that may be derived from salt marsh conservation.